So let's take a look at the podcast app for the iPhone and iPad. I'm using iOS 11, so make sure you have the most recent version. And I'm going to go into the podcast app. And there's basically four different sections at the bottom there. The first is Listen Now, and that's going to show you what you've got queued up. So I've already got some podcasts I'm subscribed to. It's going to show me them there. I can go to Library, which is going to give me a more detailed and comprehensive view of all the shows I've subscribed to, all the episodes I have available on this iPhone. Browse is going to basically show me the store. It's going to show me all the podcasts that I can get. These are the ones listed in iTunes. Now, podcasts are free, so having it called store is a little misleading. It doesn't cost you anything. You can go through, you can view top charts, you can view categories, and if there's something that you think might be interested in, you can go into it. You can also search. So I'm going to search, and notice I can search all podcasts or things in my library. So I'm going to search all podcasts to search the store. Let's go and look for the new podcast that I'm a part of, the Tech Enthusiast Hour. And you can see it comes up there as I'm typing, so I'm going to tap it. And there's a show that's listed. It also lists individual episodes. I'm going to go into the show, and it'll give me information about the show. And you can see a list of episodes there. Notice whenever you see an episode, you see that little cloud with the down arrow in it. I can download an individual episode without subscribing to the podcast. Of course, it doesn't hurt to subscribe to the podcast, because then you can see a list of everything. You get the most recent episode, and it's easy to unsubscribe. So really no disadvantage to that. Anyway, you can go in and subscribe by tapping that subscribe button. And now you can see it says I'm subscribed. Now when I want to see my subscriptions, I can go to Library. Under there I can go either into Shows or Episodes. Let me go into Shows, and it shows the three shows I'm subscribed to. I can hit the Edit button at the top and remove any one of those if I want. I can go back to Episodes and see the episodes that are available for all of the podcasts I'm subscribed to. So I'm subscribed to three different podcasts on this iPhone, and you can see I've got the most recent episode for each one shown here. And I can hit the Cloud button to download any one of those. So now that I'm subscribed to a bunch of shows, I can go to Listen Now, and I can see this list of episodes. I don't actually have to download it. I can just say I just want to go right into it. I'll go into this episode here, and you can see there's a play button there. And there's episode notes, links, all sorts of things. So I can hit the three dot button there as well, and I can see I've got various things. Why would I want to download the episode and not play it? Well, say I'm going to go offline and I want to listen to this episode. I can have it so it's stored here, but I'm not listening to it right now. I can also add it to a Play Next list if I want, and I can share it as well. So the various different things you can do. But the basics are that you can just go ahead and listen to it. Now there are a ton of options, but you won't find them here in the app. You're going to find them in Settings. So let's go to Settings, and under Settings I can go into Podcasts. And here's where you find all the different settings. For instance, background app refresh and cellular data are important. If you want to be able to download over your mobile network, whether or not to sync podcasts through iCloud so your Mac and maybe your iPad have the same episodes, the same shows. Only download on Wi-Fi is an option there. Continuous playback, so it automatically goes through the list. Very useful if you're, say, riding the train to work and you've got a bunch of 5-minute podcasts and you want them to just play. How often it refreshes, so it looks for new episodes. Download episodes. I have it turned off, but if you select all unplayed or only new, it would automatically download new episodes. The great thing about that is that you get some new episodes overnight. You get up in the morning, you take your iPhone, you start your commute to work, and you find that you've got those new episodes already on your device. So for most people, you're going to want that on. Automatically delete played episodes. And you want to go and make sure you have this set up depending upon how you want to use the podcast app. Now if you are going to go and listen to a bunch of podcasts, say during a commute, you're going to probably want to set up a playlist. The way you do that is you go into Library here and you go to Edit. And you can create a playlist called a station. So you can hit New Station, and I'll just call this Test. Hit Save. And you have all these different settings for this station. So I can say I want play, manual order, newest to oldest to newest, that kind of thing. I can group them by podcast so it plays all the episodes for one podcast first and then for the next one. Or I can decide how I want to include episodes. So include the most recent episode or most recent two episodes. Only include audio perhaps, or only include video. Only play the unplayed only. And I can choose which podcast. So I can say I want it to be this one and this one, but not Macmost Now since that's a video and I don't want to listen to that while I can't see the video. So you can see I've got this station now that's got two podcasts I've selected, all the options that I want, and now I go back here to the library and I can see, I can hit done here, and I see I have test. I can go into test and I can just play the first one and it will just continue to play through the list. This way you can subscribe to say 20 different podcasts, but maybe only have 5 or 6 of them on a specific playlist, like for your morning commute, maybe one for your afternoon commute, maybe one for your lunch break, that kind of thing, and easily get to them using all those different settings. And that's pretty much the only bit of customizability you've really got beyond just choosing which shows and going to individual episodes to listen to them manually. And the last thing I want to show you is the playback functionality. So say I go into an episode here and I hit play. And now while it's playing, you can see at the bottom of the screen I've got, just like in the music app, the little strip there that shows me that, you know, what is currently playing. I can tap that and it brings it up full screen. And now I can see all sorts of details. I've got a play and I pause button. I've got go back 15 seconds, go forward 15 seconds. I can continue to move up. I can set a sleep timer. So say I've got a 2-hour long podcast and I'm going to try to listen to it while I try to get to sleep at night. I can set a timer for, you know, turn off automatically after 10 minutes. I've got a speed change there. I've got the ability to do the AirPlay. And I've got three dots there for some extra functionality. I've got the episode notes I can get to. I've got what's up next in the list. So you got a lot of functionality there. You even have the ability to scrub back and forth and jump around in the podcast.